Musk has revealed the first Starship payload mission to Mars, scheduled for next year, and his strategy is nothing short of impressive. The timeline is ambitious. However, if there is one company renowned for challenging boundaries, it is undoubtedly SpaceX. Meanwhile, the Falcon 9, having overcome a series of challenges, is now barreling ahead at full speed, breaking records and cementing SpaceX's unrivaled supremacy in the sector. An exemplary example of this is the Crew 10 mission, a significant triumph that once again underscores SpaceX's vital contribution to the advancement of the International Space Station. Let's talk more in today's episode of NR Studio. Starship has been on a rapid upward trajectory. However, it has also faced major setbacks, particularly during its last two flights. The ships have exploded prematurely, prompting significant concerns and skepticism about the program's trajectory and progress. Despite these challenges, however, Super Heavy has consistently achieved successful landings using its Mechazilla arm, maintaining our optimism for Starship's long-term success. Recently, that optimism reached a new peak when Musk officially revealed SpaceX's most ambitious plans yet for Starship. He stated that Starship will begin its journey to Mars late next year, carrying Optimus. If the upcoming landing is successful, human landings could potentially begin as early as 2029, though a 2031 timeline seems more likely. This is truly remarkable. SpaceX originally aimed to launch its first payload mission to Mars in late 2026. This timeline is incredibly ambitious, giving SpaceX engineers only a year and a half to meticulously prepare and execute the groundbreaking interplanetary journey. What's even more astonishing, however, is the payload itself. Inside the Starship is Optimus, a humanoid robot engineered by Musk's Tesla. If this is anything to go by, it's because SpaceX has done similar things before. Remember the maiden launch of the Falcon Heavy in 2018? The mission famously carried Musk's Tesla Roadster and a Starman mannequin into the abyss of space, quickly becoming one of the most symbolic moments in space exploration history. Now, 9 years later, SpaceX is poised to achieve a similar milestone, albeit on a much larger scale. A new rocket, an innovative payload, and an unprecedented destination. Are you excited about this mission? Express your support for SpaceX by commenting. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible journey. Now let's get to the topic of the timeline. As Musk has indicated, if SpaceX successfully launches and lands Optimus on Mars, the company will immediately scale up the mission, facilitating a crewed landing in 2029, or at the latest, 2031. This timeline aligns with Musk's previous statements from late 2024, in which he articulated SpaceX's intention to conduct an uncrewed Mars mission within 2 years, followed by a crewed expedition 4 years after that. In order to achieve this goal, SpaceX will need to make a substantial effort commitment. With just 18 months left, the company faces a series of critical milestones to meet to stay on track. Gaining proficiency in Starship's flight trajectory is a critical milestone, ensuring accuracy and reliability on every mission it undertakes. Optimizing landings for Super Heavy and spacecraft using the Mechazilla arm is critical, as complete reusability is fundamental to the success of those vehicles. At the same time, improving payload deployment methodologies will be critical to achieving operational efficiency on future missions. Arguably, the ultimate challenge lies in demonstrating effective orbital refueling, a critical technology that promises to revolutionize deep space exploration, particularly in the context of Mars missions. To demonstrate Starship's readiness, SpaceX must conduct a series of crewed and uncrewed test flights, rigorously testing the vehicle's capabilities before committing human lives to it. In addition to the test flights, rapid advances in Starship's manufacturing, launch infrastructure, spacesuits, and life support systems are critical to facilitating sustained operations. As time goes on, SpaceX is being forced to function at breakneck speed to realize this bold vision. However, the Optimus initiative only marks the beginning of our journey. Next, SpaceX must conduct a series of successful missions to demonstrate its ability to reliably transport payloads to Mars. While Musk has indicated that 2031 is a more likely timeline for a human landing, I remain optimistic that SpaceX could accomplish this feat as early as 2029. If they succeed, it would give the United States a significant advantage in the race to Mars, especially as China aggressively pursues its own aspirations for interplanetary exploration. Despite the many challenges ahead, SpaceX has strong grounds for optimism. In addition to Starship's immediate progress, the company is also building a strong presence in the global launch market. Musk recently revealed some impressive statistics. SpaceX is projected to transport more than 90% of the total payload mass from Earth to orbit this year. China's growth is projected to be around 5%, with the rest of the global landscape, including the entire Americas, also expected to be around 5%. Once Starship launches at an accelerated pace, SpaceX will likely transport more than 99% of Earth's payload mass to orbit. This is critical to transforming Mars into a self-sustaining civilization. He then underscored his aspiration to make interplanetary travel to Mars accessible to all who wish to embark on the journey. This statement highlights Starship's ultimate goal, which goes beyond exploration to encompass the idea of colonization. His vision is clearly articulated, a future where humanity thrives as a multiplanetary civilization. It's important to remember that Optimus will be an early catalyst in turning that vision into a reality. Let's show our support for him and the entire SpaceX team as they embark on this incredible journey. Who can answer that? The next travelers to Mars could be us. Are you ready? In other developments, SpaceX made a remarkable comeback with the Falcon 9, once again asserting its supremacy in the commercial launch sector. Previously, I discussed Musk's bold goal for SpaceX this year, which involves carrying 90% of the world's payloads into orbit. There's no doubt that the Falcon family of rockets, especially the Falcon 9, will be critical in achieving this goal. However, the past few weeks have presented significant challenges for the Falcon 9. Following a failed booster landing during a mission on March 2nd, SpaceX temporarily suspended Falcon 9 flights for over a week. However, they have now resumed operations with renewed vigor, setting new records and demonstrating their formidable capabilities. Most impressively, SpaceX accomplished the incredible feat of executing 3 Falcon 9 launches in a span of just 13 hours. At X, the company enthusiastically announced that the Falcon 9 successfully completed 3 missions in about 13 hours, delivering 4 astronauts to the space station, deploying 7 rideshare payloads into orbit, and boosting its constellation with 23 additional Starlink satellites. Musk then praised the SpaceX team for their incredible achievement in executing 3 successful rocket launches in just 12 hours. The inaugural mission, dubbed Crew 10, blasted off from Launch Complex 39A at exactly 7:03 p.m. Eastern on the 1st, transporting 4 astronauts to the International Space Station. I'll talk more about that mission later. Just 8 hours later, at 2:03 a.m. Eastern Time on the 15th, SpaceX executed the Transporter 13 mission from SLCE in California. The mission deftly delivered 7 payloads into orbit, marking SpaceX's 30th attempt of the year. The mission's designated booster, B1081, landed smoothly in the landing zone, marking its 13th flight. More importantly, it was also a successful landing of a Falcon 9 booster, a monumental industry milestone that is unlikely to be matched by any other company in the near future. Musk marked the occasion by congratulating the SpaceX team on the successful landing of the Falcon 9. The achievement was significant, especially after the booster landing failure earlier this month, because it demonstrated the resilience of SpaceX's landing technology in the face of sporadic challenges. At exactly 7:35 a.m. Eastern Time on the 15th, SpaceX successfully launched its 3rd mission of the day from SLC-0, placing a total of 23 Starlink satellites into low Earth orbit. The mission's designated booster, B1078, successfully landed on the Just Read the Instructions drone ship, marking its 18th ascent. SpaceX's ability to execute 3 successful launches in such a short time frame underscores its incredible efficiency. While some attribute this proficiency to its numerous launch pads, no other entity currently has the ability to optimize resources and execute launches at such a pace. SpaceX is essentially reshaping the industry benchmark. With the successful completion of these 3 launches, SpaceX has now completed a total of 31 Falcon 9 missions by 2025. They are back with renewed vigor and still have 9.5 months to go to achieve their ambitious goal of surpassing 180 launches this year. Stay tuned. This is just the beginning. In conclusion, it is worth noting that among SpaceX's 3 recent missions, Crew 10 has emerged as the most important. This was the first Dragon mission to the International Space Station as part of NASA's Commercial Crew Program. After liftoff, SpaceX skillfully executed stage separation with the mission's booster, B1090, achieving a perfect landing in Landing Zone 1, marking the second successful landing. SpaceX's Dragon capsule separated from the second stage, beginning its 29-hour journey to the International Space Station. At exactly 12:00 a.m. Eastern Standard Time on March 16th, Dragon successfully docked with the station, officially ending another exemplary mission. Musk shared footage of the docking process, accompanied by a simple but triumphant message: SpaceX Dragon successfully docked with the space station. The handover was imminent, as Crew 10 was scheduled to spend 6 months aboard the ISS, culminating in their return to Earth in October. This mission was significant for NASA as it set the stage for Crew 9's return. The crew consists of two Starliner astronauts who have been confined to the ISS for an unprecedented 9 months due to ongoing complications associated with Boeing's Starliner spacecraft. Their return is currently scheduled for the morning of the 18th, with a projected landing time of 5:57 a.m. Adjustments may be required due to weather conditions in the east. Let's look forward to a smooth and safe return journey. Crew 10's victory further underscores SpaceX's important contribution to NASA's continued ISS operations. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you all for your support.